thing that will really excite players is the introduction of all this cutting-edge technology that we're just infusing into the sandbox. I think just having the comeback of the helicopter on the battlefield, it just introduces a whole new layer to the sandbox. It just gives players so much more tools that makes it more Battlefield than it's been in a very long time. We really enable our players to be really, really creative with the tools we give them. And that's what Battlefield is kind of all about. Being in a massive, open war setting and being able to say like, hey, there's a problem over there, go solve it. And the players actually choose how they want to solve that problem and through that process create their own Battlefield moments. So in 2042, you will experience three really distinct experiences. The one we're talking about right now, we're talking about today, is the experience that we call the all-out warfare experience. Now, this is the place you go in 2042 when you want to have those classic Battlefield experiences, this massive war where it's, you know, air, land, and sea, just coming together in these massive battles. But we've actually made a distinction between two separate experiences within the all-out warfare experience, and that's Conquest, which is a very much a staple for our franchise. It's something that our fans know and love, and we're just taking the Conquest experience to the max this time around. Conquest is all about the freedom, the access to the sandbox, being able to choose where you fight, how you fight, where you want to go. But it's also experience that will allow players to kind of choose their own pacing. And there's moments in Conquest where it's complete chaos. When a lot of players just converge on a single point and the chaos goes up to the maximum. But there's also moments within Conquest where, you know, you've just had that big battle and now you've won that battle. And you go like, okay, you bring up your map and you have a conversation with your friends and you say like, okay, where do we want to go next? Oh, we need to go over there to that state. Okay, how do we get there? Oh, let's call in a vehicle. And a vehicle, you can call it in wherever you want. And then your friends, you hop into the transport vehicle and you go across the map and you go to a new location where there's a new fight. So Conquest is just that full freedom to the sandbox. And right next to that lives the other experience within All Out Warfare, which is Breakthrough. And this is a significantly more guided experience. It takes you on a journey throughout the entire map. And in Breakthrough, there's an attacker and there's a defender team. And we kind of compress them into fighting head-on in a specific space. So the time to action is short and the level of chaos is really, really high. There's helicopters and there's tanks and there's infantry. There's just everything happening and it's just complete chaos in Breakthrough. So All Out Warfare kind of takes these two fan favorite staple modes and we make them distinctly lean into their specific strength. And that's on the Xbox Series X and the Xbox Series S, you will actually be able to play All Out Warfare experiences up to 128 players, which is a double to what we've done in the past in the franchise. And this is really, you know, you can have those moments when you're playing 2042, when you're sitting in the helicopter and you look down and you just see this, you know, sea of tanks, soldiers, infantry, helicopters, fighter jets just moving in unison and you kind of get this feeling that you're part of something bigger, like a really, really massive army. And that's the strength of the massive play spaces that we're building. And to be able to really make this play really well, we've altered our way of handling level design. Because it wasn't just as simple as, you know, just making it bigger and then portion the locations out. It doesn't really work that way. So we've leaned into a new type of design mentality that we're calling clustering. Now, with clustering means that you will have a massive battlefield in front of you. But within this massive battlefield, you will have particular clusters of objectives. So the map Hourglass is set in Doha, Qatar. And it is, I'm not going to go into any specifics about exactly how large it is, but it is definitely one of the larger maps that we will have in 2042. It's one of my favorite maps personally because it has some really, really cool distinct locations within it. Down to the south of the map, you'll have a fully destructible village. And this is a great space for infantry and vehicles alike because you know as a Battlefield player that infantry is skulking around inside the buildings, but you know, when you're in your tank or your attack helicopter, you can just, you know, can destroy those buildings and get access to the infantry. And you can go further east and you'll find a bunch of high rises, skyscrapers. And so there's a whole section there where you can enter the skyscrapers, you can go up to the top of them, you can zip line between the roofs, have fights in between the rooftops. But if you want to change it up even more, you can basically skydive off of the skyscrapers. And if you're playing a particular specialist that has access to a wingsuit, you can actually glide across the entire map space and get yourself all the way over to the stadium, which is on the east side of the map. And the stadium itself, it's a place you go when you really want to just take out your shotgun and have some close quarters combat. So the mentality here of building larger maps, but creating locations within that map where there's a particular type of gameplay. And with the Conquest game mode, for example, you will also see the fact that if you want to capture the entirety of the stadium, it's not just to go there and capture one location. You actually have to capture multiple locations within the stadium in order for you to kind of to consider it yours, that your team can actually get benefits from it. So lots of dynamic moments on Hourglass. And if you saw in the gameplay trailer as well, there's a massive wall of sand moving across the entire gameplay space. So what happens when this massive wall comes, of course, it engulfs you in the storm itself. But as it passes by, it leaves the entirety of the map in a different mood, in a different light, and it changes the visibility for the player. And this is a really good time for you to lean into our plus system, where you have the capability to actually alter the customization on your weapon. But I'd also like to mention, though, that the wall of sand is one thing, right? But there's also the possibility of the tornado. And the tornado is this massive disruptor that just comes into the play space, and it, wherever it goes, destruction follows. It's a massive moving physical entity that will pick you up, throw you across the map, pull helicopters into it. It's just a crazy, fun physics experience that happens as you play the map. So everything is in the hands of the player. This really is a sandbox. And these moments are in the hands of the player. While in other games, the battlefield moments are pre-scripted, in our game, they just happen. And they happen differently every single time because it's players controlling what's happening around you. That's something that you only get in Battlefield. And that's why I love Battlefield so much.